Okay, so this is the gimbal for the Mavic Pro Mark 1. I bought it last week with damaged gimbal and some slight damage to the body of it as well. We have a brand new body for it. That's actually all that's wrong with it. The ribbon cable itself, where it meets the bracket just here, is torn. So I picked up a new ribbon cable from eBay for about 15 quid. So we're just going to give it a go at swapping out the ribbon cable, and hopefully that cures the problem. What was happening was, it'd start up, it would go up, down, and just stop mid, and then just like, sit there, and then randomly it would kick forward and back. But the actual ribbon cable is just about making a no more. And it's a very small little tear in it. I don't know if I'll be able to show it to you on the camera, but we'll try. There's two screws to hold the actual gimbal onto the gimbal mounting plate. So you just slide it off to one side. You should be able to get it out like that. There's two screws gone. Stuck with a bit of tape. Right. This one side is not needed for the minute. I don't know if you can see that. There's a gap just there where it's torn. And there's basically about two or three strands of a copper trace inside in that, which is supposed to give a connection from this up to the motor, and that's torn. I'm hoping that's all that's wrong. If not, it could be a more expensive fix, but we'll give it a shot. So in my previous video, I've shown how to take the gimbal off one of these, so I'm not going to bother going back and repeating that again. If you need to see how to take the gimbal off the Mavic Pro, just check out my other videos. Actually, I could link it in the end if you want. So once you've got that plate off, you'll see there's a piece of tape holding this down. And in here we have a little connector that has to be popped off. Make sure this is right before we go too far. That's the one for there. Yeah, looks about right. Just release the tape to get the cable out. You want to prise him up. So, using something sharp, if you can get in it. Just like that. Save that tape for the new one going on. Okay, so in the back of this top plate has two screws in it, but there's also one around the back hidden in here. So we'll start with him. it's kind of stuck in with silicone as well at the edges. Just to keep it from vibrating loose when it's flying. Now we need to find our third one, which goes into the back of this. Pop this one out of the way for a second, if we can. So we want to put this bit back in first on the new one. So when we're laying it out now, we want to see what weight was. It's sticky on the inside, obviously. They popped into place. Okay, so I'm going back to the old ribbon now just to check to see what way this all folded, because I want to try and get it right. So this piece here is this piece here, and it wrapped around the motor, so we kept all of this flat piece beneath this bracket. And I brought this piece back up, so I need to bring... In fact, it might be easier just to pop that back off. Do my changes and put it back in again. Be very careful when you're popping these, because you'll do damage. They're very fine. Okay, so this piece here already comes taped and all. That needs to be bent back up on itself. So that matches that. Okay. The rest of it seems to be reasonably straightforward, I think. and then we sit in. Let it in after a bit of faffing about. So stick the tape up against that, and then we need to go and divert this guy back in. Before that, actually, I have these small bits of double-sided tape. I don't know if they're going to work. I had proper tape for it, but I just can't find it. These are actually pull tabs from an iPhone battery. They're really sticky. I'm hoping that they work. If they do, it'll get me out of a bind. Once this is stuck down, it shouldn't come back off. It's ridiculously sticky. Ask anyone that's taking a battery of an iPhone, they'll tell you. To make sure I have enough pull on it before I stick it, or it'll not come off. That should be fine. I mean, back getting stuck. Doesn't want to come off it now. Okay, so that's full lock that way. Full lock that way. And nothing's binding, which is important. Yes, it moves freely, not binding on anything. Was kind of catching on the glue there, but that's sorted. And this part moves freely as well. So we're just going to double check these connections to make sure they're pushed down fully before we start. So that one's down fully now. Might actually put that cover back on. just need to make sure this one's in place fully. Appears to be. Tabs it in the corner first. Once it's in, the rest of it just goes up. Just make sure the ribbon is flat. Like that. Tighten these tight, but not too tight. If you tighten them too tight, you'll crack the plastic. Don't ask me how I know. Okay, so this cable has to come around this way, in from the top, like so. It's kind of a bit fiddly because of all the turns it's taken, and the cable is quite springy, so just take your time with it. And once it pops in, you know it's in. Okay, so once that's in, put this back cover back on, making sure not to pinch a cable. So again, just test everything fits and turns. That goes fully that way, which is fine. Tilts back that way, plenty of room. This has to go back on here now. This cable goes on the outside, this cable goes up through the center. So, I just need to fold that cable in on itself neatly. make sure everything's sitting as it should. You don't pinch the new ribbon cable or you're back to square one. Carpet on the desk is great for stopping stuff from getting damaged, but it's a pain for screws. Just double check that you've not unpinched before tightening any further. Okay, so this cable goes on here. Like so. And this long one was on here. That's pretty much the gimbal rebuilt. Again, when this came in, all these rubbers were damaged, but I happen to have a spare one from a previous drone. It just pops out, so just check to make sure they're okay when you're changing this, because it needs them to be 100% or you'll have a problem with the gimbal. But anyway, I've checked all that already, so the next step, we'll get this gimbal in first. This cable needs to be aimed up through this hole in the back, like so. And it just literally just pushes up into position like that. I didn't remove the screws fully the last time, just to make this easy. Give one screw there. You have one screw here. You have another here. Here. You see, put your finger underneath when you're trying to get a bit of pressure on it. You want these pretty tight because you don't want them to come loose. And the last one. Okay, so inside the drone, you've got this ribbon connector, which just pops into place. Just make sure it's down fully flat. I just like to use a flat object, because at least you know it's down. There, it's done. And these two on the front. That one's home. Down Tom. And then just plug this fella back in. Spin him down. Line him up and push him down. That's it. Gimbal back. And all going to plan. That would have worked. Can try that without rebuilding it, just to see. Line up the battery, push it down. Press once, press and hold.